everyone. My name is Rosemary, founder of TechAble Assistive Technology. Today, I'd like to introduce the iOS built-in head tracking feature, which will allow you to use your head movement to operate an iDevice. I'm going to use an iPhone 12 with iOS 15 software version. Head tracking is available under Switch Control Accessibility feature. So I suggest you to first get an idea of how to use the Switch Control feature in order for you to set up and use the head tracking feature. You'll be able to find more information about Switch Control from my previous videos called Control iPhone with Switch 1 and 2. I've included the links to those videos in the description section. Okay, let's get started. So to turn on the head tracking, go to Settings and Accessibility. And under Physical and Motor, tap Switch Control. Here, I want to point out that if you look under switches, I've previously set up a few sound switches. So when I make K sound, like K, K, it will select item. And if I make clock sound, like K, K, it will take you to the home screen. You can find the information on how to set up the sound switch from my previous video called Control iPhone with Switch 2 built-in sound switch. I'm gonna go back. And if you scroll down under point scanning, you will see head tracking. So tap head tracking and turn on head tracking by tapping this button. And under actions, you'll see dwell, which will allow you to set up the dwell feature. So tap dwell, and then tap dwell options. And here you can set up dwell time, which controls the amount of time you need to point and wait to select the item. Let's make it 2 seconds, which means I need to wait 2 seconds to activate it. Then the movement tolerance lets you adjust the distance the pointer can move while it dwells on an item. So for example, if you have difficulty with keeping your head still at one point, then the movement tolerance can be set to large by sliding it to the right. I'm going to keep it as here. Let me go back. And for dwell action, I'm going to select tap. So whenever the pointer is still for 2 seconds, tap will be performed. Then I'm going to go back. And then for the pointer, let's tap and see. So make sure relative to head is selected. So the pointer will move with your head movement. And then go back. And then you can adjust the pointer speed. So the pointer speed can be adjusted from 1 up to 100. This adjusts how quickly the pointer moves with your head movement. And I'll leave it as 70. Okay, so I'm gonna go back and then scroll to top. So the head tracking is now turned on and dwell is set up. So I'm going to turn on switch control so I can use the head tracking. If you did not previously use the head tracking, then when you turn on this switch control, it will start scanning the screen either as item scanning mode or as gliding cursor mode. So you need to select the head tracking from the scanning menu items. Let me show you how to switch to head tracking from the scanning mode in the scanning menu items. So I'm going to turn on switch control. And then you can see it's in item scanning mode. So I'm going to use the sound switch to bring up the scanning menu. And then I'm going to go to the next page. And then here, you can see the head tracking is in the first row. So now head tracking is turned on and it's following my head movement. So I'm going to use another sound switch to go to home page. And then let me open Notes app. Dwell. And then I'm going to type. See you later. Then I'm gonna dwell on E. I'm gonna select it from the word list. U is here. And then later, so L, another word list, and then return. Okay, and then let me use sound switch to go to home screen. This time, let me open the weather app. Okay. And then let me go to the daily weather. So I'm going to dwell on daily. Okay. And then sound switch to go to home screen. You can see it's tracking my head movement. That's how you can use the iOS built-in head tracking feature. It'll be nice if the dwell counter used in the head tracking can be paused when it's needed. But in general, the iOS built-in head tracking works pretty well, and it's a great accessibility feature. That's all I have for today. Thank you for watching.